Matching for causal inference is based on the idea that two groups of subjects can be matched on some or all characteristics to see if certain interventions affect outcomes in one group more than in another. In this tutorial, we will explore eight different matching methods for causal inference using R. The eight matching methods are nearest neighbor matching, optimal matching, full matching, genetic matching, exact matching, coarsened exact matching, subclassification, and cardinality matching. Causal inference has well-established packages in R, but not in Python. This tutorial provides an example of using R packages for causal analysis in a Python notebook. If you are a Python user, please follow the steps in the tutorial to set up the environment to run the R packages. If you are an R user, please ignore the Python code and use the R code directly. R code are the ones starting with %R or %%R. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import libraries. Firstly, let's install DAWI for dataset creation. Then, we activate the rmagic command in the Google Colab notebook using rpy2 and install the R packages. This tutorial uses both Python and R in the same Colab notebook. For details on using R with Colab, please check out my tutorial How to Use R with Google Colab Notebook. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. The datasets is imported from DAWI for dataset creation. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Packages from rpy2 are imported for Python to R conversion. Then we imported the R libraries for different matching methods. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the causal inference. Firstly, we set a random seed using np.random.seed to make the dataset reproducible. Then a dataset with the true causal impact of 10, 4 confounders, 10,000 samples, a binary treatment variable, and a continuous outcome variable is created. After that, we created a data frame for the data. In the data frame, the columns W0, W1, W2, and W3 are the 4 confounders. V0 is the treatment indicator, and Y is the outcome. Next, let's rename V0 to treatment, rename Y to outcome, and convert the Boolean values to 0 and 1. Finally, the Python dataframe is converted to R dataframe in order to use R packages on the dataset. In step 3, we will check the standardized mean difference between the treatment group and the non-treatment group. Method equals null means that no matching is conducted. We can see that the output shows the same counts for the matched as all under sample sizes. In step 4, we will talk about the nearest neighbor matching. Nearest neighbor matching is a type of greedy matching. It matches the nearest control at the moment and removes the matched control from the rest of the matching. Nearest neighbor matching is fast but sensitive to the order of samples. It is not optimal for minimizing the total distance because the samples that are matched later in the process can only choose from the control units that have not been matched. We can use method equals nearest in the match at R package to implement the nearest neighbor matching. The summary function prints out the matching results. Unequals false means that we will print out the matched results only. The unmatched results will not be printed out because we already have it from the previous step. In step 5, we will talk about the optimal matching. Optimal matching is also called optimal pair matching. Different from greedy matching, optimal matching minimizes the total distance across all pairs. When there are not many close matches for the treatment group, optimal matching can be helpful for finding the best matches. We can use method equals optimal in the match at R package to implement the nearest neighbor matching. The argument caliper is not used with optimal matching. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is my most referenced website for data science and machine learning. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me as a content creator and buy me a cup of coffee, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free posts each month for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 6, we will talk about the full matching. Full matching is also called optimal full matching. It is called full matching because all the test and control units are assigned to a subclass and are utilized in the matching. It is optimal because the weighted average distances between the treated and control units in each subclass are minimized. Full matching outputs weights that are computed based on subclasses. The weights can work similar to propensity score weights and be used to estimate a weighted treatment effect. In the R code, the matchIt package method equals full argument implements the full matching. In step 7, we will talk about the genetic matching. Genetic matching uses a generic search algorithm to find weights for each covariate to achieve optimal balance. The current matching is with replacement and the balance is evaluated using t-tests and Kolmogorov-Smirnov tests. In the R code, the matchIt package method equals genetic argument implements the genetic matching. Pop.size controls the runtime through the population size for the optimization algorithm. In step 8, we will talk about the exact matching. Exact matching matches each unit in the treatment unit with all the control units with the same values for all the covariates. In the R code, the matchIt package method equals exact argument implements the exact matching. The exact matching matches on all the four covariates in the equation. There are no other options for exact matching. We got the R interpreter error of no exact matches were found because there are no exactly same covariates between any treatment units and control units. In step 9, we will talk about the coarsened exact matching. Coarsened exact matching performs exact matching on the bin covariates. The number of bins impact the matching results. Fewer bins allow the units with very different covariate values to be placed into the same subclass. More bins may cause units to be dropped because of the difficulty in finding matches. A general rule of thumb is that when we have more sample units and not many covariates, the number of bins can be relatively high. If we have a small number of sample units or many covariates, the number of bins should be relatively low. In the R code, the matchIt package method equals sem argument implements the exact matching. The cutpoints option allows the user to specify the number of bins for each covariate. In step 10, we will talk about the subclassification matching. Subclassification matching forms subclasses with similar distribution between the treatment and the control group. Different subclassification schemes exist, including the matching based on the propensity score. When using propensity score for the subclassification matching, it can be thought of as a coarsened exact matching with the propensity score as the only covariate. In the R code, the matchIt package method equals subclass argument implements the exact matching. The default number of subclasses is 6. The default distance measure is the propensity score from a logistic regression model. Method equals subclass does not work with argument caliper. In step 11, we will talk about the cardinality matching. Cardinality matching selects the largest subset of units that satisfy user-supplied balance constraints and the ratio between the treated and the control units. It does not consider the distance between units. It also does not assign units to pairs or assign units to subclasses. Subset selection is conducted by solving a mixed integer programming optimization problem with linear constraints. It maximizes the size of the matched sample subject to the constraints on balance and sample size. In the R code, the matchIt package method equals cardinality argument implements the exact matching. The option tiles controls the balance tolerances. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about causal inference, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.